In this experiment, we will test the effect of enzyme's concentration on the activity of the enzyme. The enzyme that we are using is the bromelain. It's an enzyme that exists in pineapple juice, and it has the capability of digesting protein. The source of substrate for us is albumin. This is the source of protein. In the first step, we will prepare. We are testing the effect of enzyme's concentration on the activity. We will prepare different concentrations of the bromelain. We are adopting today the 1:2 serial dilution. Means I need to put in each test tube 5 ml of distilled water. And then I will add the same amount of pineapple juice to the first test tube. When I mix 5 ml of pineapple juice to 5 ml of distilled water, this is a 1:2 dilution. I have diluted my enzyme's concentration into 2. And then I will keep transferring from one test tube to another, 5 ml, 5 ml. The concentration will keep on being divided by 2, by 2, by 2. So the concentrations will be 1 over 4, 1 over 8, and 1 over 16 by the end. So I'm done with the distilled water. This is the pineapple, of course, a new pipette, also a 10 ml pipette. So in each of those test tubes, I have 5 ml of distilled water, and I'm going to add to the first one 5 ml of pineapple juice. I try to mix the components. This is the 1:2 dilution of the enzyme. Then I will take 5 ml of this dilution. Okay. And I will add them to the second test tube. So 5 ml to 5 ml. This is another 1:2 dilution. The total dilution here becomes 1 over 4. Then I take 5 ml of this diluted tube to the third tube. This is dilution 1 over 8. And then the same thing. This is dilution 1 over 16. In this step, I have only prepared different dilutions of the enzyme. We have not started the experiment yet. And the colors of the enzymes, concentration is obvious, different dilutions. We will put them and we will prepare a new set of test tubes, also labeled from 1 to 4. We start by adding in each test tube 5 ml of distilled water. So these are our experimental test tubes. The first test of test tube was only the enzymes dilution, and these are our experimental test tubes. 5 ml of distilled water in each one of them. Then we add in each test tube 0.5 ml of our substrate. The substrate of this experiment is, as I said, the albumin. I need a new pipette, small pipette, 1 ml pipette. And 0.5 ml of albumin in each test tube. After the addition of enzyme, we will add the substrate. Now we have different source. After the addition of the substrate, we will add the enzyme. So albumin is my substrate, and then I will add the enzyme. I have different sources of the enzyme because I have different dilutions. If I want to use the same pipette, I need to, of course, I need a new pipette. But if I want to use the same pipette, I need to start from the enzyme that is the most diluted to the least, the most diluted, yes, to the least diluted. because if I dip the pipette in the first test tube, it will pick up a lot of enzyme. I will not be capable of putting it in the next test tube. But if I try, if I start in the opposite direction, then I will be capable of dipping the same pipette on those test tubes. So I get a new pipette and I start transferring the enzymes. 0.5 ml of enzyme in each test tube. This is the most diluted enzyme. And then the third one. And then the second. And then the first. The test tubes has to remain incubated for a while for the bromelain to act on the albumin. And then after that, after a few minutes, I will add a bioretro agent to see how was the enzyme's activity. As you know, bioret detects the presence of a protein. If the albumin is digested into amino acids, bioret will not show me a violet color. So we will pause the video and we will get back to you when the results are out. After the incubation period, we will add in each of the test tubes 1 ml of bioretro agent to detect for the presence of albumin. If the enzyme, which is the bromelain, has digested the albumin, the color will not become violet. And if albumin is still there, the color will become violet. I think we need more albumin. So 2 ml of albumin in each test tube. 2 ml of bioretro agent in each test tube. And here are the colors. As you can see in the first test tube with the highest concentration of the enzyme, we have no more albumin at all. All the albumin was digested. In the second one, we have a small amount of albumin. The color is barely gray. In the third and in the fourth, I still have a certain amount of albumin. The color is violet and it's indicated by the bioretro agent. So this is the result. The higher is the concentration of the enzyme, the faster is the reaction, until I have in my test tube an equal amount of enzyme and substrate, then the amount of enzyme won't increase the rate of reaction anymore.